So I had geriatrics like everybody else did. And so the day that we, you know, we picked geriatrics, I was thinking, crap, like, why did I choose to get geriatrics? Because I really wanted early childhood. Because to me, they're very easy to talk to. Like, yeah, I found this one actually the hardest to present to. So, yeah. So, okay, so deciding what I wanted to do for geriatrics, I was like, okay, the only things I could think of was like nursing home and assisted living. So when the discussion board opened, I was like, okay, I gotta jump on this, and I put assisted living. So I got assisted living, and I chose the Hamptons assisted living facility at the Pine Forest. And so I spoke to the lady. Let me just tell you off that it didn't really go as planned and kind of started not so good from the very beginning. So I called them, and the lady was super sweet. I spoke to, her name was Hannah, and she was the activities director. And she said, yeah, of course you can come present. Like, she was excited about it. So I was like, okay, great. So we decided somewhere in March. We didn't know exactly when, because this was like the second week of class and I had no idea what I was doing. So I was like, okay, I'll just reach out to you later. So then I called her again, and she completely forgot about the presentation, about, you know, scheduling a date. So we moved it to April. So I was like, okay, that's great. Well, then as the day got closer, I sent her the questionnaire about 3 weeks before, and I told her a little bit about it. So I hadn't heard back from her for like 2 weeks. So I was like, okay, this is weird. So then I had messaged her again, or emailed her again, asking, I'm like, hey, how'd it go? Like, did you get the questionnaires? You know, being polite. And she completely forgot about that. So I was like, okay, great. So I didn't get the questionnaires till the day of the presentation, and it wasn't even that many. So that was kind of annoying, but once I saw them, I was like, okay, they have dentures, and like basically the questions that I need to know, it was fine. So I was like, okay, that works out. But that was just a little annoying. So yes, that was about the questionnaires. So. Okay, so the first thing we did, we played bingo, and Heidi will not like this photo, but that was the only photo I had of bingo, because at the time I didn't get the consent forms in, because I wanted to wait for the consent forms and the pretest to go ahead and do the day of, because she told me that there was going to be 15 to 25 people. She was hoping at least, well, only 9 residents showed up for bingo. So that was like, I was like, dang, only 9? Really? But it's okay. So yeah, this is the only picture I had for bingo. But it was a lot of fun. They really enjoyed it. I didn't realize how like intense they can get with bingo. So it was kind of funny seeing them like that. And the bingo did last a little bit longer. So I was kind of like, I only had like a shorter amount of time to speak, and I was kind of freaking out. But yeah. So when I got to the consent forms and the pretest, this was a challenge. Let me just tell you this. Well, first, let me tell you about this lady right here. She was like 94 years old, and she didn't even have like a walker. She had all of her teeth in, had no dentures, and was like in great shape. I'm like, what the heck? Like, what are you doing? I was even talking to her. I was like, how the heck are you 94 years old and you look young? Like, she looked the youngest, actually, but she's probably one of the oldest people. I was like, what? So it turns out she has red wine every single day. So I'm like, okay, maybe I should start drinking red wine every single day. But anyways, so I noticed that like when I handed them out the consent forms and the pretest, that they did have like, I had to explain it to them, which I figured I was going to, but it was kind of harder to talk to them about it. Like, they weren't really understanding. So this lady in particular, oh my gosh, it probably took 5 minutes, if not longer, to actually get her to do the consent form and the pretest, which I was already lacking time, so it was kind of annoying. So I literally tried to explain it to her. I was like, okay, the consent form, I was like, if it's okay for me to take pictures, and like trying to explain it to her. Well, nothing. She just looked at it, just stared at both of the sheets. I was like, okay. So then I pointed out to the name. I was like, okay, just go ahead and sign your name if it's okay. And I was telling her a little bit, nothing, just staring. And she was the only one. Those other two were great. And so I was like, okay. So then I moved on to the pretest. I was like, okay. So I tried to explain it to her. One of the questions was asking how many permanent or how many teeth does the average adult have? And so she's like, I'm trying to count my teeth. I'm like, okay. So it took a good amount of time for her to finally fill those out. So that was kind of annoying. So it's for the actual presentation, I mainly talked about how to clean dentures, showing them the FAST method and flossing, xerostomia, and how much sugar is that. So for the cleaning for cleaning dentures, I had asked my dad, because he actually has some dentures in, and so I asked him, like, okay, like, what could I talk about that? Because I knew, like, lots of the elderly people had dentures, you know? And so when I got the questionnaires back, yes, lots of people did answer them. But, oh, what I forgot to tell you was that after bingo, a few people left. So I only had five. I was like, are you kidding me? Like, yeah, so that's what I'm saying. It didn't go as planned. I was actually getting really frustrated. But so for cleaning dentures, I asked my dad, I was like, okay, have you ever been taught how to clean dentures? He was like, no. I was like, so no one's ever told you about them? He was like, no. I was like, okay, this is perfect to talk to them about. So like I went into detail on how to clean them and everything. Well, actually the people that did show up, they didn't have dentures. So I was like, so I was explaining it to them anyways, because I was like, okay, well, if you guys ever get dentures, or if you guys know anybody who has dentures, y'all can talk to them about it. Well, they weren't paying attention to me at all. So I was like, okay, this is throwing me off, and it was just kind of, I don't know. So then Heidi went into showing them the FAST method and flossing, and I mainly wanted to show them for flossing, if they, you know, for plaquers, anything like that, because it's better for them, for dexterity and everything. And then xerostomia, they have lots of medication, so it was perfect. And then how much sugar is that? It was perfect because basically showing them all the sugar, which they had a lot of iced tea drinkers, so which was perfect. So, yeah. So here are the pre-tests and the post-tests. Of course, there was only five, so it wasn't too many. And we literally went over all of these questions, but yet they still got some wrong, or a lot of them, yeah. So I was like, are you kidding me? Like, we literally went over this. But I realized for geriatrics, they don't really pay attention, and they also have some kind of hearing disability, you know? So that was, yeah. So they weren't exactly how I wanted them to be, the scores. So that's why I didn't really go too well. Here's a picture of all of us, look how cute. But, so yeah, I didn't really go too well because I was like, I left leaving frustrated. Like, I was like, this was my target population. Not that many people showed up. I was planning for 15 to 25 people, you know? And then also, they didn't participate in anything. They didn't ask any questions. So I was like, oh well. But the main thing is, I got it done. Yes, but it was just kind of annoying.